Hi, my name is Brianna Snyder, and I'm a Board Certified Behavior Analyst with Brett DiNovi & Associates. In this video, I'm going to be reviewing the seven dimensions of applied behavior analysis, while also discussing some more recent publications regarding potentially updating the seven dimensions. This video will cover fifth edition task list item A5. Before we discuss the current research, we need to go back in time a little bit, all the way to 1968. As most of you already know, Baer, Wolf, and Risley were the founding fathers who established the new discipline and the seven dimensions of applied behavior analysis. At the time, this new discipline helped delineate the difference between experimental analysis of behavior and applied behavior analysis. For those who are familiar with the seven dimensions, you probably have some type of acronym to remember all seven. For me, I use Get a Cab. Let's start with G, generality. This means that behavior change has generality if it lasts over time and appears or occurs across similar situations, across similar stimuli, in novel environments, and in the presence of novel stimuli and people. E, effective. The procedures implemented should change behavior to a meaningful degree that is seen as socially significant. When examining the effectiveness of programming and changes in the learner's life do not occur, it still may have been somewhat effective, but was the change socially valid? This is something that we always need to consider when it comes to effective programming. According to Wolf, 1978, social validity includes the social significance of the goals, socially appropriate procedures, and the social importance of the behavioral effects. T, technological. The description of treatment procedures and outcomes have sufficient detail and clarity so that even someone unfamiliar with the program or the learner will be able to understand and replicate them. A, applied. Behaviors are selected based on the interests of the learner and stakeholders and are socially significant. Socially significant behaviors may include social, language, daily living, or self-care. These behaviors improve the day-to-day life experience of the learner and/or affect their family members or peers in such a way that they have a positive impact with and toward the learner. C, conceptually systematic. The procedures we use and our explanation of how to use them must improve behavior, relate to the basic principles of behavior analysis, and become an integrated discipline. A, analytic. This is demonstrated when a functional relationship exists between variables and the observed behavior change in some measurable dimension of the targeted behavior. B, behavioral. Behaviors are selected that are observable, in need of improvement, and can reliably be measured. Fast forward to about 20 years, and Baer, Wolf, and Risley revisited the effectiveness of the dimensions themselves. The authors agreed that all seven of the dimensions are still applicable to applied behavior analysis, but the dimensions themselves may have changed a little bit. Look at applied. In addition to asking those who are dealing with the behavior of the learners themselves, how much the behavior should change to be socially significant, there may be another outcome to look for. Behavior analysts should also account for the interactions the learner might have with others within the community and to take that into consideration when creating programs and interventions. The two dimensions, analytic and conceptually systematic, go hand in hand. Applied behavior analysis is usually considered to be analytic only when it accurately demonstrates how to make specified behavior changes and when the behavior change procedures make sense in a conceptually systematic way. Baer, Wolf, and Risley, 1987, encouraged analysts to use their best social skills, especially when it comes to conducting research. They also called for another review to be conducted in 20 years to make sure that these seven dimensions are still applicable to the science. Fast forward to 2017, Critchfield and Reed and Fryman wrote articles that argued that behavior analysts are getting in their own way by remaining too rigid to the dimensions originally set out by Baer, Wolf, and Risley in 1968. Fryman argues that they set the groundwork for applied behavior analysis, but it is not the end-all be-all. There have been at least a few articles calling for a long overdue update to the seven dimensions. It was Baer, Wolf, and Risley who urged analysts to do so in the first place to ensure that the dimensions remain current. An update would need to reflect the current times and changes that have occurred in the field since their 1987 paper was written. When using the dimensions as a guideline, it still aids in keeping out non-behavior analytic ideas in the field, but With that being said, Fryman argues that it has also kept some prominent researchers from being published in the Journal of Applied Behavior Analysis, and have since taken their work elsewhere, if at all. Additionally, adhering too strictly to the seven dimensions can inhibit dissemination and keep our field from being widely recognized. Yes, the seven dimensions are still a great guideline for our field, and yes, you'll still see them when you take the big exam. This video was meant to keep you informed and to get you thinking about how these dimensions may require a little bit of an update to remain current. For the seven dimensions to remain current, they would need to evolve in solving society's issues in the 21st century. Thanks so much for watching. For more content, make sure to subscribe to our channel.